Morning, everyone. Internationally, US market was more of a flattish, though Nasdaq shown positive direction, whereas Dow has was bit negative. The overall S&P 500 was more of a flattish. Futures are in the US market are marginally positive, and the Asian market are also showing some positive trend in the today's trade. Even the commodities are also a bit positive, though oil is flat, but aluminum is up by around 2%, copper is up by around 0.6%, iron ore is flattish, and steel, HRC steel is up by around 0.9%. So overall direction-wise, more of a positive trend is visible in the international market. I'll ask the technical team to take up first.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, all of you. See, Nifty trading below the important support zone, that is 18,000, and yesterday we see some selling pressure. See, Nifty have important support zone at downside around 17,770 and 17,700 at downside, and that is 50 DMA. And Nifty break that level, then we see some further selling pressure. Today we expect open a positive note, but Nifty have immediate resistance for intraday is 17,940, 17,970 level range. If Nifty break that level, then we expect further momentum towards 18,040, 18,100. In upper range, but Nifty failed to break and close above this important level, then again we see some selling pressure and Nifty drag towards 50 DMA, that is comes around 17,770 at downside. So we see volatile session today also in a higher range, and Bank Nifty trading near the 50 DMA, that is come around 38,350 range. Yesterday we see Bank Nifty almost touch that level, that is 38,440 near. But next important support zone for Bank Nifty is 38,350, and below that level, then we see some selling pressure towards 38,000. Upside immediate resistance place around 38,970 and 39,000 in upper range. If break that level, then we expect further momentum towards 39,500 and above range, but we expect wait for a new breakout, that is 39,000. About 39,000, then you can carry the long position. Otherwise, we see some selling pressure in higher range also. Nifty Finance also trading near the resistance zone, and we expect if break that level, then we expect further momentum in Nifty Finance. That is 18,830 is the first intraday resistance, and then 18,900 in next important resistance. If Nifty Finance break this level, then we expect further momentum. Downside 18,700 is important support zone for Nifty Finance. So all three index trading near the resistance zone. If break that level, then we expect further momentum. Otherwise, Nifty trading in the within the range. All three index. In stock specific, UPL looks positive at current level, and we expect further momentum in towards 780, 790 upper side. So we expect positive momentum in UPL. Second, Mahindra looks positive also current level, upside 940, 942 in next level. Support level is placed around 910 for Mahindra and Mahindra. Negative side, Bharat Forge looks weak. Laurus Lab also break important support zone. That's two stock place in negative side. That's it for technical. Derivative, I can carry.
Yeah, thank you, Vikas. Good morning, everyone. This is Amit Bhuktani. So, as per yesterday's derivative data, as I mentioned in yesterday's trading session, that Nifty would be in the range of 17,750 to 18,150 level, and Nifty is still holding the support of 17,750 level. While as per the OI positions, we have seen that from 17,800 to 18,000 strike call writer positions got added up near the striker. But as we compare with the 3-month OI data, 3-month OI data, In that 17,500 to 17,800 strike, and Nifty is holding a strong put right of position. So 17,700 to 17,800 will act as an important support level for the Nifty. Currently, we are seeing in yesterday's trading session that the premium got increased heavily in front of Nifty spot towards the Nifty future level. In that, we have seen that the index which were in a buying position, so hedging was seen from the index of future. So we are, as per the view of the derivative front, we are expecting Nifty to get some short covering rally in next 1 to 2 trading session with the support of 17,750 level. So create long positions and hold a long position with the support of 17,750 level for the higher range of 17,950 to 18,000 mark. As per stock specific, we expect 2 to 3 count which look positive. First one is BHEL, Bharat Electric. Second one is Reliance. And third one is Adani Enterprise. This 3 count looks positive in coming trading sessions. Thank you.
Good morning. Yesterday's results, Acrisil result was good. It has improved. Sales were up by 55% and profits by 88% year on year. We had recommended this stock in monthly as well as Diwali picks. It remains a good export play on global migration from steel kitchen sinks to quartz sinks. And yesterday, they also announced a further capacity expansion of 2 lakh sinks, taking the total from 10 lakhs to 12 lakhs. So this will become operational in FY23 and full effect will come in FY24. So there is good growth visibility till FY24 now. We expect sales growth of 57% this year and 30% next year. So we are positive here. Mayur Unicoaters result has also improved. Revenue for the quarter was at all-time high of 196 crores, which is encouraging considering economy is just opening up in terms of footwear and auto sectors. However, gross margin declined sharply because of increase in PVC resin costs. And because of that, EBITDA margin has also come down to 21% levels from around 25% average over last 3-4 quarters. As I said, with a continued revival in auto as well as footwear, we expect company to do well in the second half, and margin should also inch up from here. So we are positive here as well. Piramal Enterprises result was okay. NBFC result was decent. Asset quality was stable. This quarter, they included the DHFL loan book also. And because of that, the retail mix has now increased to 33% from just 11% in last quarter. Company will look to increase this retail mix to 66% in next 3 to 5 years. So directionally, company is moving well. Also, because of the merger, we saw that GNPA came down from 4.3% to 2.9%. So, Piramal has just bought the good portion of the DHFL's total loans. It has not bought the entire loan book. And because of that, the book that it bought had almost nil NPA. So that is how the company benefited on the NPA front. On pharma side, the segment margins declined to just 13-odd% from average of 18-20% it saw last year. We will have to see on the pharma side if the margins come up. Company did say that second half is seasonally better and margins should inch up over here. We see the stock doing well in the long run, and also tailwind in the real estate industry augurs well for both their wholesale as well as retail books. So we are positive here. Suryoday Small Finance Bank, a recent listing result is declining over here. Gross NPA, in fact, increased from 9% to 10%, and total restructured loans are at the highest in the banking industry at 14%. Collection efficiency is also the lowest at 83%. So we are negative here. If at all any clients are holding, they should be made to exit from this stock. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Yesterday, Pratap and Snacks announced the results, and results were above expectations. We are seeing an improvement after at least 2-3 quarters. So the sales grew by 13%. Also, the margins were better at 6.5%. Versus street expectation of 3%. DFM Foods announced their results and results continue to declining. We are seeing that the result is declining since last three quarters, and this is the trend is continuing in this quarter as well, where the EBITDA this time was zero despite the sales of around 147 crores. So this is a negative. JB Chemicals announced their results and results were broadly in line with expectations. Sales shown a good growth of around 33%, and EBITDA margins were little lower due to the gross margins, due to the ESOPs and non-recurring expenses, because the gross margins were stable. So this is in line kind of an expectations. Clarion Chemicals results were declining during this quarter. There's a healthcare company called Healthcare Global Enterprises. These results were above expectations. This is an onco research and onco field, and the results are a little volatile for this company. However, we have seen with the other hospital companies, this time the results were good. EBITDA margins have improved to 17.5% versus 12% last year. However, the company continued to report losses at PAT level. FDC announced the results and results were declining. We had seen improvement in last quarter. However, the company doesn't do any con call, so we don't know about the details why this did performance this quarter. So Mani Ceramics announced their results and results were above expectations. The margins also improved. So this is a second company in this field where the margins have improved in home care, in home improvement. Bharat Rasayan results were declining. Novartis India results were also declining. We have seen only one or two quarters of good performance from this company, and we have been keep saying that we don't like this Novartis in the MNC segment. We prefer Sanofi, Pfizer, like kind of names. Solara Active announced the results, and results were below expectations. The major disappointment were the margins. Also, during the con call, the company has said that this is due to the ibuprofen muted performance, and this is likely to take another 2-3 months at least. So we expect Q3 also to be a little muted. Clean Science Technologies has announced the results, and results were declining. The company has said during the con call that they have not passed on the whole price increase and the raw material inflation, and they're trying to absorb that as the whole chain in this field. So we believe that the management was quite confident about the order book and the new products coming up. So we believe that this can, though the stock looks very expensive at 69 times FY23 EPS, so we don't expect major upside from this. Even the odd commentary was quite positive. Godrej Consumer Products announced their results, and results were below expectations. Volume came at 4% versus expectation of versus expectation of 5.2%. Revenue grew by 8.5%. However, EBITDA margins were lower at 20.8% versus expectation of 22%. Natco Pharma results were below expectation. Since last 2-3 quarters, we are seeing that the company is not able to perform. Lincoln Pharma announced the results, and results were okay. Though the sales was flat at 127 crores, the EBITDA margins saw an improvement Q&Q, but flat at YOY. So this is an okay performance. We are positive on this company. We expect that company should start showing improvement in the sales growth as that the restructuring of the business is done. And also that they are merging the Lincoln Parentals, for which they have got all the requisite approval. So we expect improvement in coming quarters in Lincoln Pharma. Thank you.
Hello. Yeah. Good morning, everyone. Aptech has announced the result, and the company has posted improved set of numbers both on the revenue and margin front, with revenue growing by 73.2% Q-on-Q. Even EBITDA margins have improved to 28.6% versus QOQ of 15.7%. Share is trading at 56.8 times TTM EPS. Other than this, SP Apparels has announced the result. The company has posted improved set of numbers for the quarter. Share is trading at 9.2 times FY23 EPS. Thank you.
Yeah. Tata Steel yesterday announced the results, and the results were below expectations. The EBITDA came in at 16,400, whereas expectation was 19,100. There were two exceptional in it. One is that there was the fair value charge which company has taken and forex loss company has taken. That is around 1200 crores. And apart from that, around 1000 crores of some royalty provision company has made in the consolidated account. So even if we adjust both these to the EBITDA of reported EBITDA of 16,400, then it also it works out to marginally lower than the what was expected of around 19,100. So apart from that, in domestic market, the weakness was seen rather than the European market. Company has reported EBITDA per ton of around 15,600 or around $208 against last quarter $87, which is in line with what market was expecting. And domestic EBITDA per ton has seen some decline, that is from 32,700 to 30,700. So apart from that, going forward, what management has indicated that the European EBITDA per ton will continue to improve even in the next quarter. It seems like they are not getting much impacted because of the increase in the coal cost, cooking coal cost, which has moved up from around $120 to almost $400 right now. Maybe they might have taken forward buying or accumulated inventory over there. And apart from that, iron ore prices has come down. So European operation is likely to see further improvement from the current level, whereas Indian operations will see some decline because the Indian operation will see around $100 increase in EBITDA per ton for the company, and that will have some pressure on the EBITDA margins of the company. So overall direction wise, we are more of a neutral to negative in on steel sector as a whole, because we see that the Indian prices, which are trading at premium to most of the Asian market, and company may not be able to increase prices because of that. And even the exports to international market, which was running high in the recent past, is now declining. So they are not able to get benefit on that account as well. So overall direction wise, steel sector, we are not positive. Apart from that, Everest Kanto has announced the results, and the results is good across the board. We had seen 25% increase in the revenue. In fact, last quarter also the results was good, but the share price has not seen any substantial increase at that time. And this quarter, again, they continue to show good profit in all the regions, India and Middle East, and US was more of a stable. Last quarter, there was some exceptional gain, and excluding that, the US market is more of a stable. Whereas Middle East had shown very good improvement in EBITDA margins and revenue. And also India has shown further improvement in their performance. So overall direction-wise, results is good, and share is available at very attractive valuation. Quarterly EPS was at around 6 rupees 30 paisa, and overall the company has reported is trading at 140 rupees in today's trade. So stock can move up from here. Then Hindustan Oil Exploration has announced the results. Here again, the results has shown some improvement, though the major improvement in the result will be visible from the next quarter, and the peak benefit will be visible in the fourth quarter, when there one of the big oil well will be starting productions from somewhere in the November. So overall direction wise positive, though this result was also a bit better than the previous quarter. Then KCP has announced the result yesterday. Here they got multiple business. One is cement business that has shown good performance as compared to its peer. Another business is in sugar, which is not in India, but in Thailand, and that has also done well. But apart from that, the engineering division has not done well, and the hotel business has also not shown performance. But overall, the results looks positive for KCP Limited. Then Aster DM Healthcare has announced the result, and we see that the result has shown good improvement. Q2 is their comparatively lean quarter, but in this lean quarter, they had shown good growth and also improvement in margins across the segment. And apart from that, even second half of Aster DM is always better, and company will continue to show good results in the coming quarter. Revenue grew by 10% year on year in this quarter, and EBITDA margin has improved to 13.7 from 11 from 12% last year. So both the way stock result has shown improvement. Apart from that, NMDC has announced the results. The results were above expectation, though declined from last quarter, where they saw a good price realization for the iron ore, but iron ore prices started declining in the current quarter and continue to remain low in the current quarter as well. So the benefit of the higher iron ore prices was visible in Q1, and then it started declining in Q2, and further Q3 will see further decline. So though the result is above expectations, but the direction wise outlook is not so great. Then Astral Limited has announced the result, and the result was ahead of expectations. Here again, company has shown in polymer division growth of almost 60%. We had seen growth of around 40% for Supreme and 66% for Prince Pipe. Against that, the company has reported 60% growth in pipe business, which is indicating that they gained the market share in this market. Apart from that, management has indicated that Q3 is likely to see further move up as PVC prices has moved up, and company has already passed on all the increase in the PVC prices. And apart from that, the key benefit which will be coming is that the CPVC prices increase they had taken in this quarter of around 12%, which will be very positive for the company in the third quarter results. So overall, and demand environment, company said that there is a overbooking of the pipes. So overall direction wise outlook positive for Astral Pune. That's all from us. Thank you very much and have a good day.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel for in-depth interviews of India Inc. and press the bell icon so that you do not miss our updates.